Hello everyone, this is Sandeep Sharma here. So after the NEET results are out, many of you have sent messages, sent queries that you will may be getting DNB in one clinical specialty and whether to take DNB or to opt for MD-MS. So there are no set rules here. MD-MS versus DNB, there are some pros, some cons. So we'll be discussing all those things here. So first of all, why do people prefer MD-MS over DNB? In counseling list, you would find that most of the people tend to go in for MD-MS and DNB is relatively taken up late. One of the reasons for this is public perception. If you go by general public, many of the people, particularly in smaller cities and towns, they think DNB means diploma. DNB is not diploma. DNB is a proper 3-year postgraduate degree instituted by Government of India in the 70s. But people tend to think that DNB is diploma. So that is a public perception problem. Fortunately, this perception is changing and many of the DNBs, even in smaller cities, they have a very thriving practice when you look into the private sector. So public perception is one reason. Second reason is stipend and fees. MD-MS in general has better stipends as compared to DNB. The fees in MD-MS in government colleges, not private, government colleges is much less. Whereas in DNB, it is usually done in corporate hospitals and private hospitals, and so the fees is found to be relatively higher as compared to MD-MS. Third reason, a very important reason from what I feel is academics. MD-MS is done at medical colleges where there are dedicated teachers, faculties to teach you. Whereas DNB is usually held in private hospitals where teaching is a secondary thing for the consultants there, so academics tend to be a bit more better on the MD-MS side as compared to DNB. Having said that, there are places in India like Hinduja Hospital, Gangaram in Delhi and St. Stephen in Delhi, Kanchi Kamkoti and Mangeshkar Hospital in Maharashtra where the academic program is as good as in DNB as MD-MS. So academics is a relative thing, but yes, overall it is one of the reasons why people choose MD over DNB. And fourth is the exit exam. When you enter into MD-MS, getting out after completing MD-MS is relatively easy because the people who would be taking your exams are your own head of department and the external who will be coming, he or she indirectly will be knowing you. So it is relatively easy. You are giving exams in a familiar environment, familiar place, the familiar ward, everybody knows you, and so the pass percentage is a bit better. DNB, the exit exam is tricky. It is a pan India exam, and other than the theory MCQ part, you also have to sit for practicals. Practicals are held in a city, in a center, away from your original place of DNB. Like one of my friends, she did her DNB anesthesia from Gurgaon, but she got her center down south near Alepe. She did pass, but of course she had to go through language problems and the tension of going all the way from one part of the country to another to give your practicals. So these are small little things which add up and make people choose MD-MS over DNB. Of course, these points are not valid at all places. As I just said, some places academics are better, some places stipend are better in DNB, and certain places like Gangaram, the pass percentage is almost in the range of 80 to 90%. It varies from place to place. So is DNB equivalent to MD or MS? My strong answer is yes with a mild no. Why did I say yes and a mild no? DNB in certain aspects is equivalent to MD-MS. So what are the points where DNB is equivalent to MD-MS? If you do DNB in any broad specialty, like say you do DNB pediatrics, just like MD-MS, you can work in government jobs. You can have a private practice. You can work in a corporate hospital. You can sit in DM-MCH entrance exam, keeda hai, aur padhne ka, aur exam dena hai, you can sit in that and apply for jobs in UPSC or armed forces. So if somebody has done 3 years of MD in pediatrics, another has done DNB in pediatrics, there is one government job, one seat, both of them go together. Who will get selected will all depend upon who gives the interview better. So it will all come down to that. In these aspects, in all these aspects, MD and MS is equivalent to DNB and vice versa. The problem with DNB is if you are going to go into medical colleges and want to work as teaching faculty, you want to be assistant professor, associate professor, then DNB is not equivalent to MD-MS with some caveats. So what does it mean? These are the latest regulations given by Government of India. This is a bit tricky to read. Let me make it simple for you. Suppose I complete my MD-MS. I've done my MD, but I'm just giving an example. I do my MD. After completing my MD, I pass my MD. I have to do 1 year SR-ship minimum, 1 year senior residency minimum to be eligible for faculty position in a medical college. Okay. If you do DNB, the rules become a bit different. If you do DNB from a place, let's look at the first option, what Government of India says. If you do DNB from a place where MD-MS degree courses are also being given, like you do it from a place like AEM, MD-MS courses are there, DNB courses are there. So when the person doing DNB will pass out, then DNB is at par with the MD-MS degree. So in medical colleges where DNBs are there, MD-MS is equivalent to DNB, not only in private practice, but also in terms of faculty positions, right? Second scenario, if you do DNB from a place, usually big corporate hospitals, where there are at least 500 beds, but there are no MD-MS courses, only 500 beds are there. It is a big center, right? Then such qualification again is at par with the MCI recognized qualification. So here again, the MD-MS seat will be thus equivalent to DNB, even when it comes to teaching faculty positions in medical colleges. Third scenario, if your college has 100 or more bedded hospital, but less than this, that is the number of seats are 100, number of beds are 100 to 500. These are the number of beds in the hospital, which most of the corporate hospitals like Fortis, Max, etc. will have. So if you do your DNB from that place, the guidelines say you will have to do work for one additional year. This is very, very important. One additional year as senior resident for being equivalent to MD-MS. So here, MD-MS is not equivalent to DNB. You will have to do additional 1 year of service to gain experience to be eligible for SR-ship. So eligible ho sakte hai, but you will need to put in one extra year of government service or working in a medical college. And fourth scenario, if there is a place which does not fit into any of these, like a very small hospital, new DNB center has opened, only 45, 50, 60 beds, but DNB seat is there, DNB degree course is there, then the person will have to work for two additional years. So you will have to work for two additional years to be equivalent to MD-MS. So in short, MD-MS is same as DNB. DNB is same as MD-MS in private sector, in corporate hospitals, in government jobs. But for teaching faculty, if you do it from a good place, then it is fine. But if you do it from peripheral places, then it becomes tricky depending upon where you are choosing. So not only the branch, the place from where you do your DNB is very important. Of course, if you want to do only private practice, then these regulations are not of any use. All these regulations are related only to teaching faculty positions. So you should take up DNB keeping these things in mind. Branches where DNB is good, although there can be a significant difference, usually radiology, anesthesia, pediatrics, pathology, orthopedics, ophthalmology are the branches where DNB, people who have done DNB, they are doing as good as MD-MS, in fact, doing better than that as well. Other branches, it varies according to place. DNB medicine is something of a hit or miss. You said get it in a good college, perfect. You get it in a bad college, nobody will teach you, and so you will be left to fend for yourself. DNB surgery is tricky one. Certain places in India, they offer very good DNB courses in surgery. Almost 70% places in India, DNB surgery is in corporate hospitals. They will not allow you to touch. You do see a surgery being performed, that is fine, but unless you do it, you will not learn how to perform it. So take DNB surgery only if you are getting it at a good place. So to take DNB in clinical branch or take paraclinical MD, suppose you have a rank of around 12,000, 13,000, you're getting a paraclinical branch in MDMS and you're getting a clinical MD, you wanted to be a clinician. If you wanted to be a paraclinical person, perfectly fine with that. I must mention here, it is a common misgiving by students that paraclinical MD is inferior. No, I know so many people who have taken MD, MS in paraclinical branches and they are doing excellent in life. In fact, the quality of life in paraclinical branches is better. But again, it is an individual decision which you have to take. So here, which one to choose if you're getting clinical DNB versus paraclinical? It is a highly personal decision. As I said, you have to look at your risk appetite, what you want to do, where you want to be, private kaam karna hai, government kaam karna hai, where you want to be. So nobody can decide. So a lot of you have asked me, sir, should I go in for MD biochemistry or DNB pathology? Your choice. I am not you, you are not me. So this is one decision you have to discuss, ask yourself, discuss with family and then decide. Branch and interest is more important, except when there is a strong bond involved or the place is infamous or has bad academics, then you will obviously avoid that place. My personal take, I will give two examples here. If you do DNB pediatrics from place like Gangaram Delhi, Kanchi Kamkoti down south and Stephens in Delhi, it is much better than doing MD pediatrics from a peripheral place where there is no faculty, high fees and bad bond of 5 to 10 years. So do, if you want to be a pediatrician and you're getting DNB pediatrics in Gangaram, I would say go for it. The learning you get, the stipend you get, no bond, plus excellent academics, pass rate above 80%, this will be much better than doing MD from a place just for the sake of MD. Of course, you have to consider the teaching faculty requirement also. But on the other hand, MD in paraclinicals will be better than DNB surgery from a place. Suppose you are getting MD in pathology in one place and DNB in surgery from another place. You are flexible with the branch, so you can take pathology, but surgery is at that place which will never allow you to touch or cut the patient yourself. So please refrain from taking a branch here. You will have to struggle. See, everything is relative, but you will have to struggle a bit more after you complete your degree to gain that clinical expertise. In general, the medicinal physician related branches, DNB is preferred compared to surgical branches, with exceptions. It comes down to what is available and what place is it available. So this is my personal poll. To summarize, branch is important, but also look at academics and your own future plans. If you want private practice or simply jobs, DNB is good enough. I stay in Chandigarh. I know a couple of people who are DNB pediatrics and they have a thriving practice, even better than people who have done MD. If you want teaching faculty post, do DNB from a reputed place or be ready for additional 1 or 2 years to be eligible if you do it from a smaller place. Pass percentage is very important before you pick a branch. This is what I truly believe in. Listen to it very carefully. 5 years from today, it is not your degree, MD or MS or DNB, which will decide your success. Your success will be decided by how good your skills are, how ethical in life you are, and how well you empathize with the patient. Taking a degree, taking a seat is like marrying someone. You marry someone, before you marry someone, you meet a lot of people, you look at their merits, demerits. There is no perfect person in this world, but once you decide to settle for that person, you don't look back and start thinking, oh, isse shaadi kar leta. No, you don't think like that. You stick, you make it work, and trust me, if the branch which you have taken, you try to be the best in that, DNB, MD, MS will not matter in the long run. It is the short term thing where you are going to face the problem. So be ethical in life, take a calculated decision. And if you are working hard enough in life, all these hiccups will be a thing of the past. So all the best for whatever branch you take. And regarding pediatrics as a subject, MD pediatrics versus DNB pediatrics, what are the pros and cons of each? I will be putting a separate video on that. So thank you very much. Bye-bye.